I always liked the act of discovery. I was always interested in the great explorers. And over time, I came to love the sea. Between 80 and 90% of global trade is transported by ships. So without ships, no trade. Shipping emits about 1 billion metric tons of carbon every year. Quite frankly, now I also see a big commercial opportunity for technology companies to make that to make the marine industry more sustainable. Those that adopt digital transformation will outperform everyone else. My dream is that one day, when a large ship enters a big industrial port, the water in that port is so crystal clear and so full of fish that it is just wonderful. That's what we need to achieve. Shipping, historically, it is one of the less sustainable industries. That is because, one, the type of fuel they use is very heavy fuel, and secondly, because most ships, when they're at sea, are a black box. So you don't really know what happens mechanically, operationally in the ship until it comes back to port. Aveva is an industrial software company. That means we provide software that designs, builds, and operates industrial assets. You can today design a ship fully in the cloud, including very complex ships with more than 3 million data points. You can then take that digital twin of a ship and use it to mirror the operations of the ship. Companies collect data from these ships and then run predictive analytics that allows them to optimize the fuel consumption of their ships and save about a third, about 30%.
Here we've got a model of a vessel. It's a really cool thing to be able to give this data to someone that needs it. In the past, good luck. That information was stored on a couple of thousand pages of paper that was delivered with the vessel and no one ever looked at. If we're able to take all of the data that's out there in the port and in the wider shipping environment, apply a bit of context, apply a bit of analytics to it, we can take all of those ones and zeros and turn it into information that's ready to make decisions on. It allows us to really speed things up.
It's important to look at the entire industry, looking at the ship operators, the ship builders, the fuel suppliers, the port operators, and bring all of them in. That allows you to be much, much more efficient and take out unnecessary waiting time, unnecessary fuel spend, all sorts of unnecessary waste out of the shipping supply chain. And you can do that not just for one ship, you can do that for entire fleets.
This is a live map of the port. Now, in this instance, what we're really trying to focus on is the fuel supply chain. So you can see I've got two red dots out there at the moment, and those are two ships that are waiting to come into port. If we have a look at this environment, there's a problem where I'm currently running very low on hydrogen. So if I drag out in this environment a little bit, and I can see over here, I've got another ship that's waiting a little bit further out. It was off screen. This is a ship that we know from our manifest that is carrying hydrogen. What we're gonna do is take the ship that's further out, let it frog leap the others. It can come into port, unload its hydrogen supply. That does two things. The owner of this ship is happy. They're running more efficiently. But the two ships that burn hydrogen as a fuel source that we're waiting, they can come into port, refuel as they normally would. We've stopped three ships sitting out at sea burning fuel just to keep life support systems going. What we want to do is reduce the total tons of carbon CO2 emissions to zero. The goals that the marine industry has today are fairly aggressive, and unfortunately we don't have the luxury of waiting for new infrastructure to be put in. What we need to do is start doing as much as we can with the infrastructure and the technology that exists today, and that's where Aveva can help.
Sustainability and efficiency are generally supply chain challenges. So they are ecosystem challenges. And this is where the concept of radical collaboration, the ability to break through data silos and ultimately access the data from the different parts of the supply chain is so important, because that gives you the visibility that allows you to be much, much more efficient. So everything I have described in terms of the design process, in terms of what is possible from an operation point of view, exists today. My call to action to the shipping industry is be curious, see what exists elsewhere, yeah, adopt it to your needs and use it to outperform your competitors and do good for the planet.